This is JP from Not a Lot Over Arkham. This time I'm continuing Sister Mary's run through the Return to Dunwich Legacy campaign. I'm playing the Winchester Sister Mary version, and last time in the Essex County Express we failed to complete the scenario, but we got enough experience to upgrade the deck a bit. So let's look at the upgrades first. I added only the Sacred Covenant into the deck to help keep the blessed tokens in the back when Sister Mary uses the Winchester, so that I don't have to, if I pull like a bunch of blessed tokens out for one test, I don't have to use them all, so that I don't empty the back of the blessed tokens right away. But that's basically the only change in the deck. Because of the resolution from the last scenario, we had to remove Dr. Francis Morgan and Henry Armitage from the deck, and they are underneath the blood on the altar scenario card. So if we get kidnapped and stuff like that from the agenda, we might lose some allies underneath from there as sacrifices. But let's see how this goes. We have already set up the scenario. Only thing I need to do is to add the blessed tokens that are added in the setup. We start the game with the hired gun in play. I decided to put the hired gun in the house, the reeds, and that is a location that is not connected to the village commons. So hopefully we can find some weapons to deal with the hired gun, and that way get rid of him and try to find the secret chamber and the key. So I think that is enough of the scenario and the deck, so let's get started. I have pre-shuffled the deck, so let's draw our opening hand of 5 cards. Okay, so we get the Hallowed Mirror, Ward of Protection, Prepared for the Worst, Guardian Angel and Scene of the Crime. I think we'll keep the Prepared for the Worst so we can look for the Winchester. I think Hallowed Mirror is an okay keep, and Guardian Angel. I think the rest we can mulligan. So we get, okay, so we found the Winchester and we got the Renfield. So a pretty decent start. We have the weapon to deal with enemies, and the only thing we are really missing at the moment is a way to get clues, but I'm hoping to find some solutions for that soon enough. So I think the first action will be to play David Renfield, then get a resource and play the Winchester to be ready for the hired gun, and just try to kill the hired gun next turn. But let's see, I'll play David. David costs 2. I'll immediately add a doom and use David to generate 1 resource. Second action, I'll play the Winchester. And it comes into play with 5 ammo. And last action, I think we'll move into the Bishop's Brook. I think we are not ready to face the hard gun yet, so we'll go to Bishop's Brook. And it's a 3-shroud location with 2 clues. If there are If there is an investigator at Bishop's Brook, other investigators cannot enter Bishop's Brook. And first triggered ability, if there are no clues here, draw the encounter card and beat Bishop's Brook. Group limit once per game. So that is our turn. So the hired gun, it reads, each criminal enemy, including hired gun, gains hunter, prey, lost resources, each copy of hunted down gains peril and search. So this guy has hunter, I'll just put it here, easier for me, and so I think we'll just go here. And just checking one thing. So that is the enemy phase. Go to upkeep, draw a card, we get evidence and gain one resource. So that is the first turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom. The encounter card is, it's mobster. So mobster is a 2 fight, 2 health, and 2 evade human criminal syndicate. Retaliate forced after mobster attacks, you lose one resource. So it comes into play and it's engaged with us. So first action, I'll just use the, oh yeah, we forgot to add a bless token into the bag. I'll put that there, so maybe I remember at the end of the run. So I'll use the Winchester to shoot at the mobster. So there isn't a high chance yet to hit, but let's see how it goes. Okay, so a plus one. So we hit and kill off the mobster. And I think I'll use the evidence. So we'll grab one clue from here. Then I think I'll try to investigate. Actually, no. Let's draw cards and try to find a way to investigate better. And let's get another one. Take the initiative, so next turn we can try to investigate that. That is our turn. I think this guy hunts here. So upkeep, we draw a card. And we get another take the initiative. And we gain one resource. And that... yeah, we add the bless token back. Okay, so that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. Yeah, I also forgot to use David last turn, so we add a doom here. Then counter card is research and evils. Draw the top two cards of the encounter deck, place one doom on the current agenda. I think I'll just place the doom. And first action, will I just take the initiative? Well, before that, I'll use David, just so I don't forget to get the resource. Then I'll take the initiative, so investigating 5 versus 3. And it's a 0. So we get this clue, and now we can check the card underneath here. So we found the silver, the key to the chamber. I'll just place it. I'll just put it next to here. Second action. Let's move back here. And let's move to the church is one shroud location with one clue. After you reveal congregational church, search the encounter deck and discard pile for a copy of Kidnapped Android. Shuffle the encounter deck. Okay, that that is not good news. Let's see, well, there's one copy of Kidnapped. So I'm hoping to find the chamber as quickly as possible, so that I have charges on the Winchester to deal with Silas Bishop. We need to deal 6 damage onto Silas. But yeah, let's see this first. So we draw this. We'll test willpower 4. So I'm 5 versus 4. I think I'll commit. So 6 versus 4. Well, if we lose Renfield, we lose Renfield. That's just life then. So 6 versus 4. It's a minus 2, so we succeed. And that is that. Enemy phase, this guy moves. Well, let's move here. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, yeah. So we're running this guy around in circles. Now, what are enemies? We go to upkeep, we draw a card. Yeah, there's one clue here. And we gain one resource. And that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add another doom, so we are at 5 of 6 doom. The encounter card is another copy of Kidnapped. I think I'll just add a doom, get 2 resources. And I'll test 5 versus 4, not committing anything. Oh yeah, and we forgot to add a bless token. That is maybe the hardest thing playing Sister Mary, but it is what it is. And it's a minus 1, so we succeed. Another kidnapped resolved. My first action will investigate. I'm investigating 2 versus 1. I think I'm committing, prepared for the worst. So 3 versus 1. Okay, so we get a tablet, reveal another token, and it's a plus 1, so it's 0, let's count. So I was 3 versus 1, then I went to 0, but I went to 1, so I think, yeah, I'll just pass the test, luckily. Well, good thing I committed the card. And we'll reveal this card here. Okay, well, I have never gotten this lucky in this scenario before, but we found the hidden chamber. Just put it there. Okay, so we have the key and the hidden chamber, so let's think about it for a moment. I think I'm preparing for next turn, so I'll just play Guardian Angel for 2 resources. And I think I'm just moving in. So let's move into the hidden chamber. So we get get to flip this. So when an investigator enters the hidden chamber, advance. What was hidden? Reveal each unrevealed location. Move all clues in play, including those on each investigator, to hidden chamber. Spawn the set aside. Silas Bishop enemy the hidden chamber. Get the Silas Bishop here. One, two, three. So we have nine. Just place them over here. So we have nine clues to clear, or we have to kill Silas. Okay. And that is our turn. Enemy phase. Silas hits us. First this guy hunts here. So Silas hits us. I'll take two damage and one horror on David. And I'll take one horror here. Actually, yeah, I'll take the two damage here. So I can add two blessed tokens into the bag. We'll take the one horror on David. And that is the enemy phase. Upkeep, we draw a card, we get Ward of Protection and one resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. Oh yeah, and again I forgot to add one less token into the bag. We are at 5 of 6 doom. Encounter card is Eager for Death. Test willpower 2. Increase the skill test difficulty by 1 for each damage on you. I have no damage on me. So testing 4 versus 2. It's a skull, and it's a minus 2, so we still pass. So we have only, actually we have 1, 2, 3, yeah, we fail, we take 2 horror. That is fine. First action, we'll use the Winchester to shoot. I'll just take the initiative. I am firing 5, 6, 7, 8 versus 3. It's a blessed token. And it's a minus 3, so we still hit. And I have to use this, so we deal 3 damage. Second action, we'll use the Winchester again. I'll commit the Ward of Protection to the test. We hit a bless and a minus 4. So I am firing 6 versus 3. So I'm up by 3. I'm up by 5. Minus 4. I still hit. And that is another 3 damage. And we have defeated Silas. So if Silas Bishop is defeated, resolution 1. Okay, as you land the finishing blow, the creature's body explodes into hundreds of squirming rope-like appendages, wriggling across the ground and climbing up the walls. You're so startled that you aren't fast enough to prevent them from escaping the room. Even so, whatever that creature was, you're glad it's not dead. It's now dead. In your campaign log record that the investigators put Silas Bishop out of his misery, In your campaign log under sacrifices to Yog-Sothoth, record the names of each unique card that is underneath the agenda deck. Each of those cards are removed from all players' decks and can no longer be included in any player's decks for the remainder of the campaign. If an investigator with the Necronomicon... we don't have the Necronomicon. Each investigator earns experience equal to the victory X value of each card in the victory display. Each investigator earns 2 bonus experience as he or she gains insight into the hidden world of the mythos. And we go to the interlude, survivors. I'm not going to read that. Basically, we can include Dr. Henry Armitage, Dr. Francis Morgan, Dr. Warren Rice, Zebulon Waitley, and Earl Sawyer into our decks. I will make those choices off camera and go through them before the next scenario. We also get the powder of Ibn Ghazi into our deck. So I think this is the first time I have ever finished this scenario with every kidnapped person alive. So that's something. We got 4 experience from this scenario, so looking forward to making some changes into the deck. And next time we are tackling the hidden monstrosities in the undimensioned and unseen scenario. So that was Winchester Mary in the Return to Blood on the Altar. Thanks for watching, and until next time.